thank you for coming out to our second, I guess, annual at this point, baptism at the Wolford Home. Thank you to Rocky and Franny for doing it again, opening up to us. Woo! Thank you, Rocky, for sweating it out and cooking for us. So it's a great blessing. It's a great joy to come together and to come together for exalting God and what He's doing in the lives of people, what He's already done. So let's pray. I want to then explain baptism, what it is and what it isn't. Then we're going to sing a few songs, hear some testimonies of those being baptized, and then we're going to baptize them. So let's pray. Father, how we thank You, and we praise You for the gift of life and life eternal in Christ. And Father, we know that it cost Him His life, the shedding of His blood, the giving of Himself so that He could give us life. Father, we thank You for this ordinance, for this reminder, for this symbol today that we will embark upon, reminding us of what it means to be united to Christ, reminding us of what He did, what it cost Him, and what we have now and forevermore through His work. Father, be glorified in all that we would say. Be glorified as we would sing songs of praise to You. And Father, may we exalt You as we praise You for the gift of life for the three souls that were baptized today. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right, so what is baptism and what isn't baptism? First, I'll go to the what isn't. Baptism does not save you. This is not being born again or regenerated or brought into the kingdom. Baptism basically does one thing. It gets you wet, right? It does not do any spiritual thing for you, but it is an identification. It is a declaration of something that's already happened on the inside, and now you're telling the people of God that you have been born again, that God has saved you in Christ, and you are united to Christ. And we have this beautiful picture in Romans chapter 6, where Paul says, when Jesus was crucified and went into the grave, that's a picture of us going under the water. It's dying to the old self, dying to the old life. And when He was raised to new life on the third day, when He resurrected, that's us coming out of the water, if you will, symbolizing that we now have new life in Christ. So it is talking about our communion and union with Christ. We're declaring what's already happened, and we're telling the people of God. And we're rejoicing in what God has done. All right, so there's nothing mystical, magical, or spiritual about it, but it's a declaration. So we're going to declare the good thing that God has done, the life-saving that He has done in the soul of these three people, as they will tell us now what God has done in their lives. But it's a work that's been done, and we just acknowledge it and rejoice in it. Make sense? All right, the Bible says, believe and be baptized. They've already believed. They've already been born again. And now, in obedience to our Lord's command, they will go into the waters of baptism, symbolizing their union with Christ. Well, let us sing a few songs, Dylan.
Amen. Let's sing of the blood of Christ shed for sinners that we'll hear testimony of. Let's sing There's a Fountain Filled with Blood.
There is a fountain filled with blood, drawn from Emmanuel's veins, and sinners plunged beneath that flood lose all their guilty stains, lose all their guilty stains, lose all their guilty stains.
Amen.
And sinners plunge beneath that blood, lose all their guilty stains. The dying thief rejoice to see that fountain in His name. And there have I, though vile as He, washed all my sins away, washed all my precious blood shall never lose its power. Still all around, some church of God be said to sin no more. Be said to sin no more. Be said to sin no more. Till all the ransom church of God be said to sin no more. Ere since by faith I saw the stream thy flowing wounds supply, redeeming love has been my theme and shall be till I die. Silent in the grave, then in a nobler, sweeter song, I'll sing thy power to save. I'll sing thy power to save. I'll sing thy power to save. Then in a nobler, sweeter song, I'll sing thy power to save.
Praise the Lord. Amen. Amen. Let's sing of that mercy. Where would we be without God's mercy and his grace? Let's sing, his mercy is more.
What love could remember no wrongs we have done? Omniscient, all-knowing, he counts not their sum. Thrown into a sea without bottom or shore. Our sins, they are many, his mercy is more.
What patience!
What patience would wait as we constantly roam? What Father so tender is calling us home? He welcomes the weakest, the vilest, the poor. Our sins, they are many, his mercy is more. Praise the Lord, his mercy is more. Sins, they are many, his mercy is more. What riches of kindness he lacked.
Yes, Lord.
His blood was the payment, his life was the cost. We stood neath the debt we could never afford. Sins, they are many, his mercy is more. Praise the Lord, his mercy is more. Stronger than darkness, new every morn. Our sins, they are many, his mercy. Praise the Lord. sins, they are many. His mercy is more. Our sins, they are many. His mercy is more.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen. And because we're great sinners, we needed an even greater Savior.
Amen.
Who would give great grace and great mercy. And indeed, he has done that at the cross. Where our sins went on him, he paid the price, the debt, the penalty, and fulfilled justice for us so that we would never have to stand before God and answer for our sins. And therefore, God could pour out grace and mercy. Now we're going to hear testimonies exactly of that, the mercy that God has given him and the grace that he's bestowed. We're going to start with Jessica. Come on up, Jessica.
This is good.
Hi everyone, thank you for coming today, and here's my testimony. So I was born and raised Catholic. I went to Catholic school and did my sacraments. I believed in God, but I never understood faith, which led me to not understanding God. At one point, I didn't even have any interest in learning more about my faith. Many years later, Marco actually told me to start coming to GBC. He would always speak the gospel to me. He even gave me my first Bible. Since coming to Grace Baptist and attending service on Sundays and study on Tuesdays, I started feeling closer to God. This led to me starting to pray frequently and reading the Bible a lot more than what I was prior. Since becoming a Christian, I've had my fair share of struggles, one of them being unable to continuously read my Bible and make excuses for myself until I read it again. Then one Tuesday, Pastor Peter did a sermon on the Church of Ephesus, which is in Revelations. Something stuck out to me that was, remember, repent, and return. Remember when all your heart wanted was Jesus. Repent and ask for forgiveness. Return to Christ. This made me faithfully read my Bible from that day forward. Since accepting Christ in my heart, I started to feel joy and started to look forward to waking up and seeing what he has in store for me. I started feeling conviction for my sins. I have cut off my worldly ways, and I even started praying multiple times a day, as well as reading my Bible more often. I feel very blessed to have strengthened my relationship with God. He has helped me with everything I have asked of him. I have also let him lead my life. Now the sins of my past will now die as I come back up, and as I'll be a new person, my sins are now nailed to the cross.
Amen. Thank you, Jessica. All right, now, Maria Pizzanello.
I'm the oldest one. Everybody loves me in the church. It really is. All my brothers and sisters over here, I find a very big family. I'm very happy for that. If I start crying, don't worry. I'm crying all the time, okay? But Jessica said, I raised all my life in the Catholic Church. But since my son, he started going to Christian church, I start going with him, and little by little, I get there. And now, I'm going to get baptized in the name of Jesus Christ, who died for us. And I have a lot of things to give to God, because God was very good with me. Everything I was asking to him was very good, and to my family too. So, if I start talking, I'm not going to finish until tomorrow. I'm going to read this because it's going to be a little easy for me with the English. I am a sinner who deserves to be condemned. I don't deserve salvation. I can't do anything to save myself. Thank you, Lord, that you saved me. Salvation is through Jesus Christ alone. Thank you for forgiving all my sins, and that now I don't have to be afraid of condemnation anymore. Thank you for giving me the Holy Spirit, a new life in Christ, a life that is eternal. Thank you that nothing can separate me from you. Thank you, Lord, that you come from heaven and become a man to pay the penalty for our sins, especially my sins, because we're all sinners. Thank you forgive me the salvation that only comes through Jesus Christ. I will follow Jesus for the rest of my life. Lord, give it to me what I need to follow you.
Amen. Jesus. Amen.
Thank you. Emotional. I cry all the time. I say that.
Well, when I know that. Besides being a saint and saved, in my opinion, the best cook in the church. That's my opinion. All right, now, Maritza. And Maritza is going to say some things in Spanish, and her nephew will translate in English for us.
Buenas tardes. Para los que no me conocen, mi nombre es Maritza Belis y este es mi testimonio.
Good afternoon. For those who do not know me, my name is Maritza Belis and this is my testimony. I am from Ecuador and I come from a single parent family. That is, I grew up without a father, of which I witnessed how hard it was for my mother to raise six children. I got married at the age of 18, from whom I had three children. But unfortunately, my marriage ended in divorce after 14 long years of suffering, torture, humiliation, infidelity, and all kinds of abuse. Now I had to run with the same fate as my mother. As time went by, I don't know how or when, or perhaps seeing myself alone and without help, my life became a debauchery. I believed that everything I did was right and fun, and the more I filled myself with that messy life, the emptier and more destroyed I felt. I became a self-sufficient, strong, proud, and arrogant woman without realizing the damage I was doing to my family and even to my children. And suddenly one day in March 2022, I saw myself in this country, and although I left behind my loved ones, my land, and my culture, I felt very good because I came to live at one of my brother's house. However, I did not know what fate had for me. Soon, I began to experience loneliness, sadness, and pain, but not because I had left my country, but because a month after my arrival, I was denied hospitality and lodging in the house of that brother. And although I wanted to throw in the towel and return to my country, it was my other brother, Freddie, present here and his beautiful family, who offered me hospitality in their home. However, when everything was going well, in December of 2022, during Christmas time, and for my country in Ecuador, I received one of the most painful news I had ever felt. The death of my daughter, Andrea. The pain was so much, on top of many pains, that my health began to worsen, to the point that life no longer had meaning for me. And I remember a month before the death of my daughter that my brother approached me to extend an invitation to the church that he and his family attend. It was as if something was trying to prepare me for what was coming, because the following month, I buried my daughter. And I confess that when I returned from burying my daughter, I denied God because of her death and all of my sufferings, and I thought that in reality, he did not exist. Then I started going to church again, only to realize that I was still in rebellion against God, and with a lot of anger, just not understanding what was happening to me. And even though I tried to take refuge in every preaching, trying to find some comfort, my ears were deaf to them. Well, I don't know at which moment, but something began to happen to me. Suddenly I began to listen to the preaching, but I didn't like them. Sometimes I saw the pastor's pointing finger accusing me, and I felt that he was addressing me directly. Sunday after Sunday passed, and every time I felt accused. Something was happening to me. At that moment, I came to think that my brother had commented on my life to the pastor because I felt that he was only addressing me. After service, my brother always asked the family about the sermon, and that's when I asked him, "By any chance, did you tell the pastor anything about me?" Because I felt that he was speaking directly to me as if he knows everything about me. And that's when my brother explained to me that he did not share anything at all. But that's how you feel when you are confronted by the Word of God. Despite how uncomfortable I felt, I realized that I wanted to come back again and again. I don't remember what that preaching was, where I felt very confronted more than other times, feeling the accusing fingers Sunday after Sunday. Sometimes my throat and chest burned. Memories after memories hit my head. Sometimes I exploded in tears. And each time I felt how his word revealed the reality of my life. And little by little, it crushed me, making me feel dirty, immoral, unworthy, and ashamed. I was starting to feel disgusted at myself, at everything that came to my mind. I was starting to hate my past. I was starting to hate my past, everything I did. I think something was starting to fall from my eyes. I could see myself and feel very rotten inside. Until finally, words came out of me, and I repeated, "God, what have I done?" I wanted to turn back time, but I felt helpless, with a terrible guilt and a lot of fear. I really saw myself in hell because I did not deserve God's forgiveness. I would come home after each service very disturbed until I couldn't take it anymore. After reading a book I took from the church entitled Sinners in the Hands of an Angry God, a deep brokenness came to me. I burst into tears and I felt a deep repentance. At that moment, I was able to ask forgiveness from that God whom I had denied months before. I implored his forgiveness, understanding for the first time the true value of his beautiful blood spilled on that cross. And now I know that it was for me, that he gave his life to reconcile me with his Father. Thank you, my Lord, that I am now justified by his merit. After all this blessed experience, my life has been transformed. My thoughts have changed, and I just want to live for my Lord and Savior. I thank God for GBC because it was here that I was taught to know my God. It was here at GBC that I was taught to know my God through the exposition of His Word and in my own language, as well as the Spanish Bible study that have been of great help to me for my edification. But also, not least, I want to thank my brother Freddie, who helps me understand the Word of God at home during the times he brings biblical teachings. And finally, when I was asked if I wanted to be baptized, I did not hesitate to say yes, because now I have the opportunity to publicly confess that the Lord Jesus Christ is now my Lord and Savior. To Him be all glory, all honor forever. Amen.
Yes. Amen.
That's the best. Listen, Romans 1:16. Also, they are not ashamed of the gospel of Christ. Why? Because the power of God to save anyone. Anyone, Jew first and then Greek. The power of God to save souls. And Maritza, we praise God that He saved your soul. Well, let's get up and sing one more time.
Is it not stirring our hearts to hear of the Lord who saves? Let's sing of that Christ, our only hope in this life and in death. What is our hope in life and death? Christ alone, Christ alone. What is our only confidence? That our souls to Him belong. Who holds our days within His hand? What comes apart from His command? And what will keep us to the end? The love of Christ in which we stand. Oh, sing hallelujah. Our hope spring eternal. Oh, sing hallelujah. Now and ever we confess Christ, our hope in life and death. What truth? What truth can calm the troubled soul? God is good, God is good.
where is his grace and goodness known? In our great Redeemer,
yes,
who holds our faith when fears arise, who stands above the stormy trial, who sends the waves that bring us nigh unto the shore, the rock of Christ. Oh, sing hallelujah, our hopes spring eternal. Oh, sing hallelujah, now and ever we confess Christ our hope in life and death.
Just as we heard our sisters confessing Christ, confessing that he has made them a new creation in Christ, let us now confess to him that he is our only hope in this life and in death, unto the grave.
Unto the grave, what shall we say? Christ he lives, Christ he lives, and what reward will heaven bring? Everlasting life with him, there we will rise to meet the Lord. Then sin and death will be destroyed, and we will feast in endless joy when Christ is ours forevermore. Oh, sing high. Christ our hope is,
oh sing, he saves.
Oh sing hallelujah, our hope spring eternal. Oh sing hallelujah, now and ever we confess Christ our hope in life and death.
All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to now baptize the three ladies. But you need to know we're going to do something different with Maria. Being she's a little older, being last year she broke her shoulder and her wrist, we're not going to make her climb up into the pool. Instead, we're going to do what the Presbyterians do. We're going to sprinkle her, and it's the symbolism that counts. It's the identification that counts.
We have a bucket.
Oh, we're going to use the cup. We're not going to do that to Maria. Hey. What are you doing? All right. Yeah, we took a water pistol. So, with that, let's get Maria over here in the corner by the pool outside. And Jessica, you'll come in the pool first, followed by Maritza. And Pastor Phil and I will go in a minute.
Maria, turn around this way. Maria, based upon your profession of faith, we baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. Are you okay? All right, somebody get Maria a towel.
Towel!
Oh my
All right,
God.
We're gonna go in.
Where's Greg? Where's the towel?
I got a towel.
All right. All right. All right.
Beautiful.
All right. All right. I'm gonna take this
hand. So, Jessica, upon your profession of faith, we baptize you in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Come on, man.
Yeah, they're crazy. Based upon your profession of faith,
yes,
we now baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.